Hey everyone, it's FB here with a cast of the first qualification cup of Stadium Esports League Mix Cup Season 1. This is a new event by a new organization that myself, together with a couple of other community members, have started up. By hosting events with so-called mix maps that features elements of the most popular competitive styles of Stadium, such as tech, dirt, and speed, we hope to be able to create a common goal of growing the competitive scene of Trackmania. And before we go live into the first phase of this qualification cup, here's a closer look at its format. There will be three qualification cups in total, where your two best results will determine your ranking. In the end, eight players will advance to a season final to battle for the title. And as for the qualification format, we'll start with 30 minutes of time attack played on three unknown maps. Top 32 from the time attack will then qualify to a playoff phase, starting with a quarterfinal played in rounds mode, where top 12 will advance to the semifinal. And this one will also be played in rounds mode, where top 4 will eventually qualify to a grand final, where ESL Cup mode will be used instead. All 32 players that qualify from the time attack will receive points, with first place getting 26 points, second place 19 points, third place 16 points, and so on. Also, one bonus point will go to whoever sets the fastest time on each track in the time attack. And finally, here's a look at the schedule. The second qualification will take place next Saturday, also starting at 7 p.m. CET. And then we'll have a break over Gamers Assembly, and we'll resume with the third qualification on April 2nd, and lastly the season final on April 9th. Alright, let's bring it in-game here, as we are about to start in 2 minutes or so. And you can see that there's quite a bit of players that are on the server. Looks like we have 128 players right now, which I did not really expect, to be honest, for this first event. Maybe thought 50 players or something like that, but turns out we got a bit more than that. So yeah, we're starting in 1 minute 40 seconds, and in the meantime I guess I can explain a bit more in depth as to how this format works. So we are playing on three maps, as I mentioned. And the maps are all in a built in a mix style, which means that tech, speed, and dirt are all featured on the map. But for each map, one of the styles are more featured than the other. So there's about 50% for one style, and then 25% for the other two styles. And in addition, if the mappers wanted, they could also include some obstacle pouch. Although for this first map pack, there aren't really any obstacles to the maps. 1 minute remaining. Let's see if we have any notable players. Link is on the server, which is going to have one of his maps used. So he's not going to be able to play this cup. But as I mentioned in the start, two results will matter, or will count. So Link can still get a full result. I also see Scrappy from Planet Key Dynamics on the server. I'm not sure what's up with this camera though. Maybe you got an invisible skin. Also got some other Planet Kid Dynamics players. Flyer is one of them. So he'll be driving as well, as we have 20 seconds left. Who else do we have here? Lots of players, that's for sure. Will be interesting to see who's going to take home this first edition. Alright, we'll take a closer look at the players once we go live, which will be in 5 seconds from now. And hopefully everyone who is on the server will know what's going to happen now. We'll switch to the map that we will use. There might be some issues here, by the way, since this is the first time that we do something like this. So we'll see if it's going to run smoothly or not. But yeah, stuff can happen here, so we'll see. Alright, so one of the admin, Paltezza, is right now fixing the server. And we are moving on to another map. I think we are going live now. Need to also disable the chat, but this is going to be the first map that we are playing on, and I believe it's gonna be live now. So yeah, it seems like we can't disable the chat actually, but hopefully it's going to go fine anyway. I'll just write here, live. But yeah, in the next time we'll have to try and disable the chat so people will focus on the race. But yeah, so we are starting here on the first map. Let's take a closer look at it. The first map is going to be Alastalicious by Laximus. And this map is a speed mix map, if you will. Mostly speed that is featured on it. So as mentioned, we'll have 10 minutes of time attack on this map, and then also two more maps. And we'll see how this goes. There's no updates on the server, I realize, so it's gonna be a bit hard for me to follow what's going on here, but we'll have to do my best. Just for the time attack though. Let's follow Kilburn here as he's moving towards the ending. Seems to be a bit of lag on the server. It's possible maybe that it's not strong enough for this amount of players. May need a stronger server for next time, but anyways, Kilburn will finish, and I can't see what time is setting, which is not really good. Need to be able to see that. Oh wait, I see it at the bottom. So 114.32 by Kilburn. Marmelotti will take over first place, 101.87. So yeah, we'll drive three maps here. Your overall score or your overall ranking will determine your result here, and if you will be in the top 32 or not. Yeah, there seems to be a bit of lag, so I believe the server may not hold up. We really didn't expect to have this many players participating, so that might be why. We got, I don't know, maybe 120 or so players who are currently driving. Speed You Need is now at first place from Easy Killer. Recently saw him in the grand final of ESL CPS 16. Easy Killer versus Against All Authority, a really good final. Oh, as Mixmod is now first, and he got the speed tag, so this might be a map that's fitting. Of course, speed is it's something called a speed drift. It's very important when you drive on speed maps, and if you're good at doing the speed drift, which basically means that you keep your drift while driving really high amount of speed, that will make you go even faster. If you can do that well, then you can definitely shave off a lot of time. So Mixmod will try again. Scrappy has now taken over the lead from Planet Key Dynamics. He is more known as a tech player. So yeah, there's a bit of lag here. I apologize for that. But it's a work in progress though, so for next time we'll know that we'll need a stronger server. It's kind of hard to test, you know, 100 players on a server, so yeah, good to know. We got 6 minutes left on the clock. Let's see how many players have finished. Seems like most of them, not actually most of them. 87 players so far have set a time. Scrappy still in the lead, trying to improve his time here. No way for me to see if he is doing better or not. He's continuing to lag here. But for the next round though, the quarterfinal, there shouldn't be any lag because only 32 players will then drive. I think it's gonna be working a bit better. Scrappy through the last turn. See if he's gonna improve his time. No, he hits the wall instead. And in the meantime, we have Venik now in the lead. Plays for DDR, which is a dirt clan. So we've seen now players from all three competitive communities, the main ones at least. Of course, the Obstacle, the RPG community, is also rather big, and I did see a couple of them on the server. So Venik, no longer in lead, down to third place. Speed You Need has improved his time again, 58.20, and Saxum for BBD is at second place. Venik, though, still with a respectable third place at the moment. And it's kind of funny, the lag here is only maybe getting worse. Vinik doing pretty well, of course, on the dirt surface especially, so you should be able to shave off some time here in the end. Here he comes. 58.33, so he will improve his time and go up to second place with that. Alright, let's follow someone else. Here is Bren, who of course maybe is most known as doing really well in Zerator Cup. He reached the grand final. Wow, this lag. He reached the grand final of that cup earlier this year. Over 500 players participated in that cup, so it's kind of a remarkable result to reach the grand final, getting in the top four. So Bren right now at 12th place, Speedyneed still in the lead as we have 4 minutes left on the clock. The good thing though about this is that it's time attack, so you're not really affected by the lag. The players, that is, they can of course disable the cars and just focus on setting a good time, so at least there's that. Bren will improve his time. Yes, he goes up to 4th place, 58.48. Speedyneed still in the lead, Vennik still at 2nd, and Saxum still at 3rd place. Then we have Pex at 5th, Scuffy at 6th. As we see Scrappy up in the lead, 58.01. Really good time. So it's really important on these kind of maps that you kind of have the full package. You need to be good at tech, you need to be able to do the speed drift when you go through these speed sections, and then you need to be good at the dirt as well. In dirt especially, it's important that you keep your gears, and then that you also go close to the walls in the uphill and downhill turns. So there's a lot to master to be able to set a good time here, as Piranha will take over first place. Drives for Against All Authority, the speed team of Against All Authority. They also got a tech team, of course, who, as I mentioned, played in the CPS 16 Grand Final. So yeah, once again, I do apologize for the lag here. It's not me that's lagging, it's just that this server is not really capable of handling this many players. But for next time, we should have a better server, hopefully. So Piranha now in the lead, Scrappy at second, Bren goes up to third, 58.07. Speedyneed now down to fourth place, as Piranha still trying to improve his time. 2 minutes left on the clock, as Piranha will retire the round. Let's follow someone else. Here is Link for Lioncast, a tech player from Sweden. The best player from Sweden, I would say, together with Lund these days. See what Slink can do. He's at 12th place right now, 58.49. Trying to improve his time and climb the ranking. So yeah, I think two things we need to do for next time. We need to have a better server, and we also need to disable the chat, because can be a bit distracting, I'm sure, for the players seeing the chat. Slink through the last section here. Did not do it too well. We see Saxon passing him, so Saxon may be able to improve his time. Slink did not, I believe. No, he did not. Saxon did. 57.83 by Saxon. Not really a player I'm too familiar of. BBD, though, a clan which I think they play a lot in Trackmania Nations, the original stadium game. Only recently started playing Mania Planet Stadium as well, so maybe that's why I'm not too familiar of him. Here's an unknown player, not sure who this is, but maybe we can see. Okay, so this is Dragon from Croatia, so he is up to second place, 57.64. Speedyneed has improved his time as well, 57.53. 1 minute left on the clock, so if you retire now, you won't be able to set another time, as this lag is only building up higher, as Dragon will retire there. See who else is driving. Let's maybe go for the overview look. Doesn't really help me too much. It's very hard to keep track of the results here, but we see Speedyneed right now in the lead still. Will anyone beat him? Dragon then a second, Scrappy at third place in front of Saxum at fourth. 15 seconds left on the clock, and then we'll move over to the second map, and there won't be any break here. We'll just continue on straight away. So waiting for the countdown, and I'm probably going to take some screenshots here just because there might be some issues with the score ranking. So let me just do that. Should be enough. All right, so moving on to the next map, and I'll take a look at the time attack results once we've played all three maps. Unfortunately, it doesn't work with only one or two maps. I think there's some kind of bug with the plugin, so also another thing we'll have to try and fix. As I write live again, there's no break. So now we are moving on to the second map, and here's a closer look at it. It's 100 Highways, made by Link. And this time, this is a tech mix style. So tech is mostly represented, and then dirt and speed are a bit less represented, but it's still there though, as we follow Speed Need through the start. And this map, also not too difficult, as the first one was an example of. We did get a couple of really difficult maps submitted to us as well, but we are probably saving those for the season final. So once again, apologize here for the lag on the server. But it should be better once we advance to the next round, the quarterfinal. Top 32 from this time attack phase will qualify to that, as Speed Need leaves the dirt section and enters the speed section, which will lead him into the finish. And at the end here, you can do a bit of a speed drift through this part here, but you gotta avoid going too wide as well. Speed Need not able to avoid the wall, but it will still finish 105.98. Right now, Shumi is in the lead. Drives for SL. I'm not sure actually what that stands for, but I do know that that is a new team in the Trackmania scene. Shumi, also known as making skins. He's made skins for a lot of the teams in Trackmania. So he is currently in the lead in front of Scotsman from A New Era, and then Slink is at third place. See if we can follow someone else here, potentially. Maybe go back to Speedy Need, as he is on a deep run. Speedy Need, who is known as a very good tech player, but also a good dirt player. Famously won a very big dirt tournament 2 years ago, defeated Beppino in the grand final. So one could actually regard him as the best dirt player, or at least one of the best. In addition to being a very good tech player. So Speedy Need did finish there, 101.62. Still not really any good times here. I was able to set a time under 1 minute, so I'm sure we are going to see that before this is over. We also see Massa now on the front page. I don't think he was on the front page on the first map, but Massa, of course, very good tech player. So this map should be suiting him pretty well, even though he will have to do well course on dirt and speed as well. As I'll post a link here in the chat if you want to read more about this event. The format is listed there. So once again, we'll have three qualification cups, no registration or practice needed. We play 10 minutes of time attack on three maps, so 30 minutes in total. Top 32 will advance to a quarterfinal that's played in rounds mode. Top 12 will then advance to a semi-final, also played in rounds mode. And then top 4 will advance to a grand final played in ESL Cup mode. And then the top 8 best players after these qualification cups will advance to a season final, which will be taking place on April 9th. So that is the basic gist of it. As Massa is getting closer to the end, avoids the pillar and the wall. will set a time of 102.19, currently at 14th place. Piranha right now in the lead, 1:71. But I don't think that's going to be enough. I think a time under 1 minute will be necessary here to win. And yeah, if you're playing on the server, make sure to disable the cars. Since it is a bit laggy, as you can see. But that's because we have quite a lot of people on the server, as you can see. Lots of them, though, have quit already, but still 128 players right now. So it's packed, if you will. So Piranha will continue right now. Hobby, though, in the lead for M&M Gaming from Spain. Spain, who very surprisingly to everyone, really, was able to win Nations Cup 10 against Germany in the grand final. Hobby, one of the key players in that achievement, together with the Hobby Flyer. Not sure, though, if Hobby Flyer will be playing this cup, but Hobby Flyer was very successful in my race, FBs Weekly, which kind of, you could say maybe this is a continuation of that. The maps are sort of built in the same style, although that was an endurance race. So Hobby, still in the lead, 1:37, as you see Cappuccino, I think, going up to second place, 0.49, Bren at third place with 0.51. Let's follow Hobby here through this attempt. We see Flyer right now in the lead. Flyer not on the front page, but maybe he will be on the front page after this run. Hobby, known mainly as a tech player. I don't know if he's too familiar of the other styles. I think he did participate, though, in my race a couple of times, so shouldn't be too unfamiliar of it. As he goes through the final section, through the loop here, let's see how he does this turn. He goes for the inside line there. I don't know if that's the best idea, but he will improve his time, though. 1:09 by Hobby. That is a very solid time. Might be enough for a top 5 at least. We'll see. 3 minutes left on the clock, so I think we'll see some more improvements here. Alright, see if you have any. Oh, Speed Need was really far behind, but then improves his time. Goes up to 15th place. Let's see here, though, if you have any player that's further back, that still hasn't been able to set a good time. There's a bunch of them, of course. Here's one player that's kind of interesting. Super Noob, who is an RPG player. Hosts the ESL RPG Night Cup. And has even won it himself. So very good RPG player, but not so many obstacle parts, though, on these tracks. We didn't really get too many maps with that, to be honest. I think maybe only a handful that do have some obstacle elements to them. Super Noob right now at 58th place. See if he can improve his time. 103.19 so far. You can see the times at the bottom. Here comes Super Noob through the end. And he will improve his time. 102.50 at 54th place. Hobby still in the lead. Piranha is the one closest with 0.18. Goes for another attempt. Yeah, there seems to be something wrong maybe with the server, because apparently it is supposed to be able to handle this kind of pressure. But yeah, we'll have to look into that for the next qualification cup. As Piranha goes for another attempt. Flyer, now up to third place, 0.31. Still haven't seen that time under 1 minute, though. But maybe it will come very, very soon, as Flyer will retire. He won't get too many attempts after this. But I think third place time, though, is very, very respectable. So should be fairly satisfied with that. But as you can see, he's still going for an even faster time. Soon only 1 minute left. Flyer retires again. Let's go to someone else. Here's Benkoof, who I have no idea who that is. Let's see the login. Oh, it's Ben from 402 from France. done well on this map at 6th place behind Massa ahead of Cappuccino. Ooh, as we see, I think Marco maybe going up to 4th place. 1 minute 36 hundredths. Less than 1 minute to go here. Will we see Habi losing his first place? Maybe to Ben as he goes through the last corner. Sets a time of... doesn't look like that was a faster time. No. Ben will stay at 0.45. Let's go for the overview look here. Habi in the lead. 30 seconds left. Will anyone beat his time? That is the question. Piranha at second, Flyer at third place. Oh, speed you need! 59.86! I was wondering if a time under 1 minute would come, and it did surely come here from speed you need, 0.86! That's a very good time, and it looks like he will take first place with it. Alright, so let me take some screenshots here again, just in case something happens with the plugin. Alright, there we go. Alright, so moving on to the final map here in the time attack. Let's take a closer look at it. Or wait, maybe first say that it's live so people know. Alright. There we go. So now let's take a closer look at this map. It's called Mixed Love, made by Cass. And this is a dirt mix map. So about 50% dirt is featured on the map, and then speed and tech got about 25% featured on the map. So we are going live here into the time attack. 10 minutes is all that's remaining, and then we'll have the top 32 players divided and sorted, so we can start the next phase, the quarterfinal, which will be played in rounds mode. So Speedy Need, of course, known as a dirt player, almost goes wrong there. Lots of players did. It's a bit hard to know for sure where to go at first, but it's not too difficult of a map, just like the first two ones. It's rather easy, as Speedy Need will then enter the speed section, which will be the last section of the map as well on this map. Got a loop here and then a hard turn to the left. Gotta be careful here. Speed Need will make it. Setting a time of 106.49. His teammate though is in the lead, Paxmauer. Tom at second, Speed Need at third place, but these times will of course be improved for sure. Eight minutes left on the clock. Time does move quickly, that's for sure. Gotta make sure that you make it count. Got still Paxmauer in the lead. Tom at second from Mad Drivers, Polish clan. Trying to improve his time. Then we got Raga from Team Fox, another dirt clan. Currently at fifth place. So this kind of map should suit him rather well. See if he can take a top position. Edward now in the lead, another player from Mad Drivers, also from Poland. Oh, did not last for long though, as Habi sets a good time, 1 minute 65 hundredths. It's amazing really how quickly these players can learn this map. Can't remember exactly what is considered a good time here, but I'm very sure of it being a bit faster than Habi's current time. Probably maybe down to even 58 seconds, we'll see. Kilburn now goes up to second place. Habi will go for another attempt. Get through that part. Speedy Need now back in the lead. got Scotty driving as well from Exception, also from France. A lot of French players participating, which I guess isn't too surprising since it is a French game after all. The players don't know the map, that's correct, Flowstar. So the maps are released at the start. You get 10 minutes of time attack on each of them, and then your rank will determine if you advance to the next phase or not. Top 32 will qualify. For the season final though, we'll have the maps released 1 week before it starts, and they will be a bit harder than these maps. Alright, so Scotty driving here, as we see Bren, the first one to go under 1 minute, 59.92. Let's follow Scotty though to the end, see if he can improve his time, 101.40. Through the loop, here's the last corner, Scotty goes too wide and misses the finish. So that will not be an improvement. Meanwhile, we have Speed You Need in the lead once again, 59.66. I think Speed You Need may actually be in the lead in the overall ranking as well. He's been doing well on all the maps. See if anyone will beat him. Yes! Yes, someone will. Bren now in the lead, 59.58, and then Venik, 59.41, who is a dirt player. And we have Elephant in the chat, always a pleasure to see him be active where he likes to be active the most. So Venik going for another attempt. Still in the lead, but we see Dragon taking second place, 59.47. Also a contender for maybe first place overall. Speed Need now down to fourth place as Venik will retire. Brendan in the lead now with 59.23. I think we may see a time under 59 seconds here. Maybe it will be by Bren. Epic asks, does it have a cash pool, this cup? No, we don't have any prizes for the first edition, but who knows, maybe for the second one. If anyone is interested in sponsoring us, then let us know. As we see Bren retiring, let's go to someone else. Here's Santana, who is a good player for sure. Right now at fifth place, 59.72. Got 10 players under 1 minute so far. As Santana will retire, we got less than 3 minutes to go now. And then there will be a bit of break for us to collect the results. The quarterfinal will be starting at 8. So we'll have 25 minutes or so until we start that round. Maybe a bit earlier too if we can gather the results, but we'll see. Alright, Santana retiring again. Let's go to someone else. Here's Cappuccino for Against All Authority, who also will retire. Yeah, we really gotta make sure that the chat is disabled for next time. It's quite distracting. 2 minutes left on the clock. Bren still in the lead here with 59.23. Will someone beat him? Cappuccino may be capable of that. Already got a good time. but hungry for more as he starts another attempt here. Let's go to someone else though. Someone we maybe haven't followed yet. Here's Ray Raven from Door to Q, which I think started as a Canyon team, if I'm not mistaken. Currently at 17th place. Massa has gone up to second, 59.30. 700s behind Bren. Let's follow Ray Raven though, as he is about to finish another attempt. See if he can improve his time. And maybe get under 1 minute as well. Here he comes. Ending looks good. And it is an improvement from Ray Raven. 59.78. Puts him up to 11th place. 45 seconds left on the clock. Bren still in the lead here. 59.23. In front of Massa with 0.30 and Venik with 0.41. Will that be the podium for the final map? Seconds left now, still no. Oh, Habi actually goes up to third place, ties with Venik, 0.41, but there is also a thousands milliseconds, so well, I guess they could still be tied though, but likely Habi did set a faster time. Up to third place, 5 seconds left on the clock. It looks like Bren will take it. Alright, so that's gonna be the end of the time attack, and now we are going to gather the results here. Let's see if the results are already in, actually, after this is over. I forgot to take the screenshot, shit. But hopefully, though, the plugin will work.